going to Oregon.
All right, 7 o'clock in the morning.
7 a.m. just exactly right now.
No, stay out there.
Bus is on. We're ready to go.
Ready to go.
Ready to go. Off to Oregon. Coach, I understand this is the first time that the track team has traveled out of state. So talk about that a little bit.
The logistics that comes with trying to get 29 student athletes, 35 combined athletes between both genders, trying to figure out where points can be spread, but also not taxing the athletes too hard or too much. That was quite an undertaking. Coach Kelly and myself had we've been working since last November to ensure that this trip could be plausible. So something like this is very difficult to orchestrate and do, but now that we've done it once, we're gonna do it again and again and again. It's gonna get easier and easier. We were very fortunate to have a group of kids that were just unbelievable, well-behaved, were very appreciative, showed very strong character. So I'm very proud of that.
All right, Coach, as of right now, your team is undefeated in league. One more league match with Dana Hills coming up. And how do you think this meet prepared you better for league?
The one thing I did not want this meet to be was a distraction to our season. We brought 29 athletes, but this is not our whole team. What I would like to do is when we get back, we start focusing on our next dual meet against Dana Hills. We also have Orange County Championships. It'll be a lot of fun for the student athletes to see how good they are compared to the rest of Orange County. But our sights are still on elite championship. Dana, for the boys, is gonna be very difficult. I believe the girls have a good shot, but they're gonna have to fight hard. But the one thing that I do think is that our season is not over by any stretch. And we need to continue to persevere and strive for greatness. And we have to remember that there's a long-term goal in mind, and it's not just the Oregon Relays. So the Oregon Relays is not the pinnacle or the highlight of the season. It's just one of the many highlights. We plan to be a strong representation at CIF Finals, Division I. And we also plan to be at the, make our presence known at the California State Championship in Clovis, Buchanan High School in June. And so we have much to do, but we continue to push on, and the kids are ready for it. So it'll be a good season. I think this trip was a complete success. It gave our athletes an idea that outside of Orange County, or even just Southern California for that matter, there is a greater world of track and field. Prefontaine ran here. University of Oregon is known for this. And the stadium that we ran is where the Olympic trials are, where the World Championships will be in 2021. This is the Mecca for all track and field. That probably is the greatest facility in all of the world. So our kids got to compete there. And not only that, but another thing that they saw was that outside of Orange County, they're pretty good.
And Coach, how was it just being here on the track, on this historic track, and just being a part of all that?
On our first night, we actually were walking and one of the guards was distracted and the gate was open. So I thought, we probably should just go in there. So we did. Thursday evening, before any of their teams were here, our entire team got to walk the stadium, walk the track. I even jumped over the steeplechase and got wet. And I mean, there's nothing that beats that. I'm sure in heaven there'll be a track just like this. We got to see where the university football team practices, plays. We got to see the campus as a whole. We received a tour. Our kids are getting an idea about colleges and majors and what life at a college is like. So I'm very proud of my coaching staff. I'm proud of the kids. I'm just excited that this is gonna be a traditional thing that we get to do year in and year out. Our team got the full experience. They got to feel what it's like to be a college athlete. They got to feel what it's like to be a college student. We got to walk the campus each and every day. Our hotel is across the street from the university. We ate at the same places that the college students would eat at. We even got to get a tour of the entire football facility. I think that this gave our athletes an idea about what it's going to be like or what it could be like and to be a college athlete. So I think there's a lot to be gained here, more than just good times and good marks. It's an experience that we came for, and experience is what we got. We will definitely be back next year, God willing. I believe that our goal right now is to come back and take first and maybe put our stamp on the entire state of Oregon.
Tyler Kraft, talk to the race today, man.
Oh, I know, I just
got out hard, maintained the race, and just went well.
Now, how do you feel about your time?
I could have gone faster, but 11.31, I'll take that, especially at a first place in Oregon.
All right. Congrats, man.
Thanks, man.
I'm really happy with the team. It's an interesting dynamic that our team has right now because we brought four freshmen, we brought a number of seniors, and anyone in between. The men's 4x1 team was a freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. One thing that I was very happy about with the team is that for both the boys and the girls teams, they're young. And not only just young, but they're very mature in their approach to their training, they're mature in the way they compete. Tyler Kraft just proved that he was the fastest freshman in the state of Oregon and Washington, as well as Canada for that matter. We looked online. Right now he's the fourth fastest in the state of California. And he's just a freshman. We had Brian and Natalie and Trinity all run great distance races. We had leadership such as Nick Ramirez and Chris and Luke in the pole vault coming off pretty significant injuries. We had almost everybody represented. We had distance, we had sprints and relays, we had pole vault and shot and disc. As a whole, I believe that Trabuco Hills is more about overall team. And as a team, they came and they performed well. I think we can come away from this trip with a lot to learn, but more importantly, they should feel very happy about how everything turned out. I'm very proud to be Trabuco Hills Mustang. I'm very proud to lead and work alongside some of these athletes. And I think year in and year out, we're gonna continue to be maybe one of the better teams at the Oregon Relays. So I think coming away from this trip, our athletes are gonna leave with more confidence in their ability. I believe that coming back from a trip like this not only made us more of a team and closer as a team, but also I believe they realized that they have a ways to go to be and achieve some of the goals, but I believe they're more hungry than they were before this trip. To get my pole vault poles to my rental car, first floor. This is my option. What? How am I gonna get 16-foot poles? Where do they need to go? I'll let you know.